Greetings. This is Prophet Wes. I just want to today give you a brief word of encouragement. I'm going to try not to be too long. I know I can be long-winded at times, and I just want to encourage you in the Lord. And my thought comes from Philippians 1 and 6. And Apostle Paul was talking to the church of Philippi. And he said these words in this, I am confident in this very thing, that he who has begun a good work in you will perform it unto the day of the Lord. In other words, what he was saying is that what God has began, the work, the anointing, the encouragement, the building that God has to begin in you, he's increasing your love. He's increasing your understanding on him. The gifts, when God gave you a gift, God gave you a promise. God gave you a promise that he's going to bless you. God gave you a promise that he's going to keep you. God gave you a promise that he's going to heal you. God gave you a promise that you're going to hit your target. God gave you a promise that you're going to be the head and not the tail. The Bible says that he who's performed a good work. See, the thing about it you need to understand, the only thing that God can do is good. All gifts that come from God is good and very good. And the thing about it, the good work, it starts from a seed. And God's seed is life. His seed is joy. His seed is victory. His seed is love. And so his seed is going to be good. His seed is authority. His seed is an overcomer. His seed, when you want to give up, it tells you that you got to rise. His seed tells you when you want to lay down, it makes you stand up. His seed will tell you within yourself when you're in the valley of defeat that I am an overcomer. His seed that will tell you in the presence of your enemies, he will prepare a table before you. I'm talking about his seed, the one that performed. He's begun that good work. That good work that he started. Because the Bible said the race is not given to the swift or the strong, but to him that endure. And see, in there between the beginning and the end to the promise, you got to endure. And what will make you endure? God's power. What will make you endure? God's word. What will make you endure? God's anointing. The Bible says that our faith cometh by hearing, and hearing by the word of God. Which means that the more you listen to God, the more you incline your ear to God, the more you become an intimate with faith, which means your confidence will grow, which means your love will grow. And that will cause you to know that you can make it. See, because the thing about the Bible says that faith is the substance of things hoped for. In other words, look at this. Faith is like legs that's on a journey trying to get to its destination. And as faith is walking this walk through hearing God's word and going through this journey, going through the process, going through the wilderness, going through the trials, as hope, as God is calling you to your destination, as God's calling you to your purpose, you've been hurt, you've been knocked down, but you get back up. The Bible says the righteous man falls 7 times, but he'll get back up. The Bible says our steps are ordered by God. The Bible says all things work together for good. That means the good and the bad and all of that. The steps of the righteous man are ordered by the Lord. All of that, that's all a part of his good seed. All a part of that good work that he's began in you. But the thing about it, that same work, as he's going to finish it, he's going to perform it. In other words, God did not repent for saving you. In other words, God did not repent for what he put in you, but what you've been through. You've been going through changes. You've been going through upheavals, and you think that your changes and what you're going through define you. But what you're going through don't define you, but what God said define you. Because the thing about it, what you're going through, it's just there to ignite your power. It's just there to get you closer to God. See, because Paul said that our glory in my infirmities, that the power of Christ might rest upon me. In other words, when you're weak, that means that God is making you strong. God is making you a warrior. God is strengthening you. God is sharpening you. God is making you ready for battle. God is getting you ready for the fight. God is saying you can make it. That's why the Bible said I can do all things through Christ that strengthened me. I know how to abase and I know how to abound. And that's why Paul said, looking back, leaving those things that are behind me, forgetting those things, and I'm looking for those things that are before me. I press forward toward the mark of the prize of the high calling in Christ Jesus. And you see, there's a press in you. That's a part of that good work. That's a part of that seed. See, God has put a press in you. For the Bible says that since the days of John the Baptist, the kingdom of heaven has suffered violence. But the violent take it by force. In other words, that means the ones that are bold. That means the ones that are courageous. That means the ones that say enough is enough. And see, there's an enough is enough in you. And so what you need to do and what you're going to do, as God speaking to you, you're something you're going to activate. When you're in your situation, joy is going to activate. When you feel weak, strength is going to activate. When you feel confused, understanding is going to activate. And God is going to get the glory. And so as the Bible said, what God has begun in you, he's going to perform it unto the day of the Lord. It's because your promise is calling you in. And so you're in the right place. See, what God is doing, his sound is shedding off weaknesses. It's shedding off all kind of stuff. And it's making you free. It's giving you a victory. And it's giving you a voice. Be encouraged. Amen. God bless you. A little brief word. God bless you. And heaven smile on you. Be encouraged. Be encouraged.